Hi everyone, it's Carolina from Gotta Love Polish. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you're new. In today's video, I decided to do my top OPIs, but with a twist. Now, this video was inspired by Miss Thompson, and she does have a YouTube channel. I will have her details down below. She did a video in March of 2020, and I have had a list that I wanted to share with you all based on her video since April 22nd of 2020. That's when I made this list. And I'm finally getting down to actually recording the video. Around November of 2022, I actually did some live swatching of the polishes that I wanted to talk about. But with one thing and another, I just never feel like I had the time to actually record the actual video. And now I do. So the pictures and videos that you're gonna see of my nails are completely different than what the state of them are at this moment, because it was from 2022 and my nails are no longer that shape slash length at this time. So the parameters for this video, the twist, if you will, is that I have to pick my top OPI polishes based on the last 10 years and then pick a favorite polish from those 10 years. Now, when I was making this, that would have ended around 2018. That's what the list is gonna consist of, because honestly, after 2018, actually I wanna say after 2017, I really did not buy that many OPIs. Like, the collections didn't speak to me the way that they used to before I got into indie polishes. I mean, that's just being honest. Indie polishes have kind of ruined mainstream a little bit for me. I mean, don't get me wrong, I enjoy a good cream every once in a while, but creams were never my thing, and I feel like I have all of the colors that I'm gonna have right now. And if I don't, then it's just onesies or twosies. But I feel that from the core collection and up to 2017, I was really obsessed with OPI, or I have a lot of really good ones from those previous collections. Also, I will be talking about the colors that I've actually worn, not the colors that I may own but still haven't worn. Because if I haven't worn them, how can they be a favorite? These are all the polishes that I have worn and have enjoyed and want to say these are my favorite. I also tried not to pick just fall polishes. However, fall is my favorite season. Fall has always been my favorite. So we're gonna start off with the 1989 launch collection, which is honestly, a lot of their core colors are still available. The one from that collection is gonna be Malaga Wine. Now, this is a polish that I accidentally de-stashed at one point and realized, I didn't de-stash it, I gifted it to a friend because they really liked it. And then I realized I made a mistake, because I actually love Malaga Wine. So this is my second bottle of Malaga Wine. I love this color. It's such a chameleon. I feel like in certain lights it looks red, and then it kind of turns into this brown, and then at other lights or angles it kind of looks like I don't know, like a oxblood kind of color. I don't know, but there is something magical about Malaga Wine, and this is like, if I won't say it's my favorite OPI of all time, but it's pretty dang close. And now, starting from 2008, we're gonna start off with the Love Me Not. I always wanna say Lerve, because I said it as a joke one time, and it kinda got stuck, so now when I talk about it, I'm always like, you know, Love Me Not. And my friend knows exactly what I'm talking about, but it's Love Me. See, I can't even say it right anymore. This polish was a polish that I actually tried on later, like way later, because I didn't think there was anything special about this polish. This is a beautiful purple polish. It has a shimmer in it. It gives it this depth and dimension when you put it on the nails. Looks fantastic. With the shimmers, it's almost like an indie polish. Like, this polish is so good. And I just did not expect it to be as good as it was, because in the bottle, it's so unassuming. It's like, yeah, okay, it's a pretty purple with shimmer. But no, it is pretty purple with shimmer. Like, I love it. So I do have a bonus polish for 2008, and it's actually kind of like, wow, I can't believe that this is like my bonus polish for this year. But it was Tickle My Francie. I know, right? Tickle My Francie. 2008 is around the time when I really started getting into polishes, but I was still in the military. So I was very much used to browns and nudes, or barely there kind of colors, because at that time, we weren't allowed to wear like colors. It had to be like a neutral or like your nails but better kind of thing. No French manicure, no crazy colors, absolutely nothing like that. So I was very much like, my collection mostly consisted of shimmers and creams that are on the neutral side, but Tickle My Fancy was actually one of the neutrals that I really, really enjoyed when I wore it. I don't know what it is. I mean, I look at it now and I'm just like, it's beige, it's boring. But when I wore this, I thought I was like the bomb diggity. It was so surreal how much I loved this polish. I shook it, so you can't see how much of a fill line I have for it. But it actually, I have a pretty decent fill line for this polish because I just wore it so much at the time. For 2009, my favorite polish for that year is actually Smitten with Mittens. This is from the Holiday Wishes collection. And even though I got this polish later in life, like I did not purchase it during the time that it released, I purchased it later on. I was very lucky to find this polish for a decent price. It wasn't like scalping me for this polish. Once I wore it, it sealed itself as one of the prettiest reds that I can own in my collection. And so because of that, Smitten with Mittens is my favorite for the 2009 year. The bonus polish for 2009, it's actually Pampelona Purple. Before Smitten with Mittens, I would have said that this is my favorite polish for 2009 because I wore this beast like crazy. This is actually my second bottle because remember, this is around the time that I got out of the military. I was allowed to wear colors and purple was my go-to color after I left the army. I just could not get enough about purples. For my Helmers, the first color that I actually had two drawers on was purples because they're so pretty. And Pampelona Purple, oh my gosh, this color was my go-to. It came out in the Spain Fall collection of 2009. However, I felt that this color was bright enough to be used during the summer. There's something about this color that looks amazing no matter what time of the year. And honestly, at that time, I wasn't really a seasonal polish wearer, but this kind of color I would still wear any time of the year, especially on my toes. I don't know why I love it on my toes. For 2010, my favorite polish for the year was Ski Till We Drop. This is a dark teal polish from the Swiss collection. I think it was Swiss collection. I loved how this color looked on me, especially because this is when I started loving creams a little bit, and I had no color that looked like this. Again, my go-to colors were purples. Well, they started off as neutrals, shimmers, and then became purples and all of that entails. And then I got into teal, and this teal, to this day, I feel like this is the prettiest teal that I own. It does lean a little bit on the green side. I mean, I don't know, it's just a perfect balance, I feel like. I leave it usually in my blues drawer, so maybe I consider it more of a blue, but it does have a lot of green in it as well. There actually is one polish that I would say is a close enough dupe to this, and that is, oh my gosh, what is it called? CIA Color is Awesome. And I do believe that I did a comparison of these two colors. If I did, I'll have it up in the card because they actually discontinued Ski Till We Drop, and CIA Color is Awesome, I feel like, took its place. And I actually have three honorable mentions for 2010. I know. I just couldn't not name these polishes as some of my top polishes from OPI. But there is Catch Me In Your Net, which came out in the summer of 2010. It was a trio, I think, or a quad. Oh, this is my favorite. This actually has a pretty decent fill line. This is a stainer on me, but I love it anyways. I don't care. It's just like mermaid nails before mermaid nails were cool. The second honorable mention is Absolutely Alice. Oh, this came out in the spring. It was a movie collaboration with OPI and the Alice in Wonderland, and it was basically a collection full of glitters. And at the time, again, I was really into shimmers and glitters before I was into creams. And this one, oh my gosh, I actually accidentally skipped out on it because this was still during the time when I did not realize that polishes were limited edition. I don't know why. I mean, it's 2010. I was already shopping for a while. But for some reason, I was like, oh, I don't need this. You know, and if I like it, I'll get it later. I couldn't get it later. It was too late. So absolutely, Alice, have to say honorable mention. And the final honorable mention for 2010 is Jade is the New Black. This one I actually did not like when it first came out. I don't know why. There was something about this color that I just didn't get. I didn't understand the hype. This one, I changed my tune once I actually wore it and fell in love with it many years after it was released. I mean, that's the story of my life right now. Now I get the hype. I love this polish. Moving on to 2011, and we have my favorite polish of the year is Warm and Fuzzy. And again, I shouldn't have shook this because you will see a really, really big fill line, because this one is like the glass fleck that was really popular around that time. And it is kind of sheer, and I usually have to do 3 coats to get it to the opacity that I like. Now, I don't think I have a backup of Warm and Fuzzy. I'm 99.9% sure that I don't. So once this runs out, I'll be done, and it will run out eventually because I use this as my Thanksgiving manicure or pedicure every year since it came out. So basically since 2011, this has been on either my mani or my pedi during Thanksgiving. And actually right now as I'm recording this, it's the week of Thanksgiving. I will be wearing this along with a couple of others in a possible Skittle manicure. And the honorable mention for 2011 is gonna be Teenage Dream. Now my Teenage Dream has faded a ton compared to how it looked when it first came out. What's really crazy is that I saw this collection at Ulta, I think it was, and I picked up the blue, I can't remember what it was called. It was a Katy Perry collection. I picked up the blue, and also not like in the movies, and I did not like them. I thought they were so sheer. I didn't understand, again, I was young, and I didn't understand the concept of jellies. I was used to having opacity. I did not like sheer polishes. I still don't like sheer polishes for the most part, but I can appreciate a sheer polish now. Back in 2011, I could not, and I didn't. So my camera died. I don't know what got recorded. I don't remember where I was. So we're gonna continue on. And my top polish for 2012 from OPI has to be Goldeneye. Now I tried not to shake it, as you can see. It's very well loved. This is that famous glass fleck finish that was very popular during this time. I do need 3 coats to get to the opacity that I enjoy. I believe I have a backup of this polish. But if I don't, I know that Zoya makes a pretty dead-on dupe with, oh my gosh, I can't remember the name. I can't remember the name of the Zoya polish that is a dead-on dupe for a Goldeneye. But this is my favorite polish because it looks like you dipped your fingers in gold. Like, it's so sparkly and so pretty. I can't say enough good things about this polish. I love gold, and normally I'm not really into super yellow golds, but there's something about this color tone or finish or something that just really does it for me. So that's my favorite. The honorable mention for 2012 has to be Every Month is Oktoberfest. I know. How could this not be my favorite? And it is. It's great. I absolutely love it. But I don't know. Goldeneye just has, it just does it for me. And I've obviously used this one way more than I've used this one. And not to say that Every Month is Oktoberfest isn't beautiful, and I love the way it looks because those lit from within polishes are right up my alley, but there is something just special about Goldeneye for me. So that's why this one is the top, and this is the honorable mention. For 2013, my top polish for that year that OPI did is OPI Solitaire. This is a liquid sand or pixie dust, or basically it's a textured polish. This was around the time when the textured craze was like in full swing. This was from the Bond Girls Liquid Sand Summer Collection, I believe. It was my go-to sparkly, easy to use white. I just 2 coats and that's it. Around this time is when I really started falling in love with white polishes. Now I think a lot of people know that I like, if you watch my channel, you know that I like white polishes. But during this time, to me, white was still really like, I don't know, taboo. Again, it's really hard to shake 8 or 9 years of conditioning where you are used to doing one thing or one color, or one shade range, and then to branch out to new stuff is very hard, or it was for me. And this, I don't know what it was, but there was something really special about this polish. I loved wearing it on my fingers. I wore it a couple times as a petty, and yeah, I mean, I didn't even like try to like top coat it. I literally wore it the way it was meant to be worn, and I haven't worn it for quite some time, but you can still see that it has a pretty decent fill line. So yeah, I don't know, I still love it, it's great. For 2014, my favorite OPI of that year is Do You Have This Color in Stockholm? Oh my gosh, this totally blew me away. I just did not expect to love this polish as much as I loved it. Now, in the bottle, it's very like, I'm looking at it on the monitor, and it's like very, I don't know, it's purple, it's pretty. It's like an indigo purple polish, but purple. I don't know how to explain it. It's dark, but really bright at the same time. Orly Synthetic Symphony comes to mind, but Orly Synthetic Symphony is a little bit brighter than this one, I think, if I remember correctly. But this is like the fall shade. This came out in the Nordic Fall collection of that year. I feel like this is the fall version of Orly Synthetic Symphony. I don't know, it's just beautiful. I love this color. I remember it's perfectly opaque at 2 coats. It is vibrant, it is just stunning. For 2015, I'm sure it comes to nobody's surprise that my favorite polish for that year from OPI is, it's a Piazza Cake. I mean, come on! Of course I'm gonna choose this one as my favorite polish that OPI came out with in 2015. And trust me, there were a lot of like close runners. None that I would choose for an honorable mention. For me, honorable mention is ones that I'm like, they were so close that the winner won by a hair. For 2015, there is nothing else that compares to It's a Piazza Cake. Ever since I purchased it when it came out, it has been my go-to fall color every year. I don't know what to tell you. It's perfectly opaque in 2 coats. The formula is pretty good. I have a wonky brush, but I have learned to deal with the wonky brush. I don't know what else to say about it. It's the perfect burnt orange for me. It always makes me think of fall. It's so pretty. So yeah, this would have to be my favorite for 2015, bar none. For 2016, my favorite polish OPI came out with is Never a Dullest Moment. Never a Dullest Moment came out in the Washington DC fall collection. I told you I was trying not to pick all of the fall polishes, but those are my favorite, I can't help it. This is my favorite mustard yellow, and it's not even that mustard, but compared to other yellows, it comes across as a mustard. This polish has been my favorite year after year. I remember when I first put it on, I was with my best friend, and I think I've told this story before, but I was with my best friend, we were going somewhere, and she was like, that polish is so disgusting. And or something to the similar effect. And then when we got to the place that we were going to, which I believe was the DMV or something with my car, the lady who was helping me was like, oh my gosh, I love that color that you're wearing. I'm like, thank you. So she totally validated the fact that this is a wonderful color. And even to this day, it's still so pretty. There are many mustards. I have a lot of mustards, but I always go to this one. I don't know, it's something about it. I like how bright it is, but still mustard leaning. And it has a pretty decent formula for a yellow. That's another thing that really impressed me, because up to this point, all of the yellows that I've tried were kind of crappy formula wise, and this one had a decent formula. And for 2017, which is the last year that I'm going to talk about for the OPIs that I fell in love with, for the year, is Less is Norse. I know, how can I not say this one? It was either this one or the Susie with the Arctic Fox, I think it's called. I can't remember what it's called. But Less is Norse really surprised me, because it's a dusty purple leaning dark blue color, which looks really unassuming in the bottle, but on the nails, I don't know, there's something about it that makes me just think, I'm a badass. And And I love that feeling. No, something about this polish really, really works for me. It's just really impressed me. When I was going through the list of all the polishes for 2017, this is the one that I was like, yes, I love this one. I wear this almost every year. Not every year, but I try to pull it out as often as I can. If I don't get to wear it as a manicure, I definitely try to put it on as a pedi. I think I wore it last year as a pedi. I think I wore it last year, period. I'm pretty sure I wore this again last year because it's just so beautiful. And every time I put it on, I get reminded about what a beauty this is. So that's it. I went through all the polishes that I absolutely loved from OPI from the launch till 2017, because again, I was just going through the years that I was actively collecting OPI. When I first made my list way back in April of 2010, I actually had a couple of others that I didn't mention. Catherine the Grape is from the Fall Russia line, and that was back in 2007. I decided to start from 2008 because that's really when I started my nail polish journey. I actually found Catherine the Grape way later. I think around 2010 is when I discovered Catherine the Grape, and it's still a favorite, but it wasn't part of the 2008-2017 time frame plus the launch. Even though I talked about more than just 10 polishes, those are still the favorites for each year that came out. A lot of them were fall, but what can I say? Those are my favorite. I hope you enjoyed this video. This is many years in the making for me. I love the idea, so thank you so much to Miss Thompson here on YouTube. It was a great idea. I wish I would have done it sooner, but again, I finally did. Hopefully I'll get this video up before the end of 2023. If not, this video will be uploaded in 2024. Gosh, I hope it doesn't take me that long. So that means it'd be like 4 years in the making. Cause again, I started this back in 2020 and it still hasn't been uploaded. If you like this video, please don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. And I'll see you all in my next one. Bye.